Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calorie. Enjoy everything. Nolan has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He makes his way out to about the 35. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From their own 35-yard line, first down. Makes it to the 44.
That brings up second and one.
Just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Hey, it's a first down for this offense that keeps everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
Tackle at the 44. So they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
Second and 13. Ball on the 44. Now he tries to buy some time. Looking for the corner. Catches it. Brought down at about the 49. Gets out to about the 48-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. Oh, excellent punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Whitaker's the guy that doesn't seem to be bothered when he goes on the road. Herbie, we talked to him this week. I think he likes it sometimes better than playing at home.
I agree with you. And also, he just has that intangible that he has an ability to just block out all the noise. And whether it's the media talking during the week, whether it's the fans and how loud they can be, he's just one of those guys that's able to block it all out, focus on what he needs to do, and then he provides outstanding leadership for his team in this tough environment.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Here's the pass, broken up.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
That makes it second and 10.
They come out on an empty backfield. Good tackle there in space. From their own 43-yard line. First down. Caught out in the open. He goes out of bounds at the 46.
That'll make it second and 7.
Carrier, and he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
Third down.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. going to try and scramble. Tackle made at the 49. He might have a chance. Nice run, and he's brought down. From the 43-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. And he's immediately tackled. From the 21-yard line, first down. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That makes it second and six.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Tack on any yardage.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. And he makes it out to about the 11-yard line. This is the 13th play of this drive. Flips it middle to the running back. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
That makes it 7-14.
We've played one. No score here. Ready for more football here in quarter number two. And down he goes at the 13.
That brings up third and 12.
From the 13-yard line, third down. He throws it. Got his receiver. Touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he adds the extra point. A long 15-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He was tackled immediately. That'll be a loss of one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Caught with room to work. the 50, and he hits him hard at the 47.
Man, that was an impressive-looking play. When you can slice apart a defense like that, it puts a seed of doubt in their mind.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. He's tackled at the 48-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Quick pass going back to his running back. And they make the stop at about the 41. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They'll bring him down at the 38. First, looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
I can't argue the play call. The defense just did their job by standing their ground. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick pass. He's taken down right around the 46-yard line.
Second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Big opening. Makes it to the 41.
Speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 27. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled at the 18-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Carries the ball for a nice game. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
And he's taken down at the 16-yard line.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Third and 14 coming up here. Ball on the 17-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
That's a D4 number. That'll make it fourth and 10.
And if they can connect on this one, that'll put them up by a couple of scores. Kicks up, and he's got it. teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
He sends this one deep.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. That's a great tackle at the 34-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Got a man. Watch out here. Steps out of bounds around the 41-yard line. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 7-yard completion.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. Here's the halfback on the screen. Tackle at the 49-yard line. The Falcons are going to call their second timeout. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
He is such a good target, really anywhere on the field. But they like to get him the ball in short to medium range situations.
First down, and he's knocked out. Brought down right around the 4-yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
Fires quickly. Touchdown.
Just kills everything this defense has worked for in this first half. You can't let them score with no time left.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. He makes the PAT. A great first half comes to a close. 10-7, Bears.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. A tight, hard-hitting, low-scoring affair.
Great affair.
This
great.
Is right,
you can say it like it is.
This is right in your wheelhouse, Pollack. I mean, this is exactly in your comfort zone.
No, absolutely. I mean, you like to see people flying around. You like to see defenses dictating to offenses and make them play on our terms. And it's fun to watch. It's something that every great defense prides themselves on tackle. You know, you didn't see very many missed tackles in the first half that led to big plays. And try to limit those big plays. And when they do get down towards the red zone, make people kick field goals. And that's how you see dominant defenses year in and year out. And that's what we're seeing today.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Red and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. And he is drilled at the 27. The running back gets two on the carry.
Woo!
I think everybody in the stadium felt that hit. He really laid some lumber there.
It's second and eight. Ball on their own 27. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. Run up the middle. They keep it on the ground and get the first down.
Give credit to the big boys up front. They did an excellent job of allowing the back to get nice yardage there.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. And that'll be a gain of 10 by the running back.
That'll make it second and inches.
To about the 34-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Loose football. And the offense picks it up.
And they will keep the drive alive by recovering their own fumble.
And this drive stays alive for the offense. He's gobbled up in the backfield. So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. He's going to go for the home run. Doesn't get there.
Vincent's intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's out to the 30. He's to the 40. Across midfield. Inside the 30. The 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Weber ready to kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's stopped behind the line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 23. Runs outside for a nice game.
Gain of 5 on the play. That makes it third and 7.
he's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down.
That makes it 4th and 12.
Gibson is the deep man awaiting the return. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's to the 40. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Pretty good-looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Tackled after a decent pickup. Good run by the quarterback.
The thing that impresses me is the decision making. He sees an opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
So nothing fancy about this offense. They just run the same play over and over.
Get ready. Number 4 might be coming up right here.
First and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Made at the 24. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of 1. Makes it out to about the 16. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He did not get to the first down marker. He's going to be short. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Lumpkin gets 7 yards on the play. So at the end of the third quarter, the Falcons lead 14-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He's going to try and scramble. It's on the ground. They fall on it. And they make the stop at the 35-yard line. And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
So we're early in the fourth quarter, still a lot of football left, but in a game this tight, every possession is going to make a difference.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
From the 21-yard line, it's first down. Takes it out to about the 10.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 35-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So our score, 21-10. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Falcons have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
So the offense comes out after their last drive, had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
Makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. He's scrambling. Stopped in his tracks. Nolan to punt. He really got a hold of that one. Tackle at the 36-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He's tackled at the 44. Bishop gains 8 yards on that play.
That brings in second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's taken down around the 48-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. Bishop picks up about 4 yards on the play. From the 44-yard line, second down. There he goes. He'll bring him down at the 29-yard line.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
Tackled right around the 26-yard line. The back gets 3 on the carry. From the 26-yard line, it's second down. Hand off inside, and he's quickly brought down.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up, and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
hit out of bounds around the 26-yard line. Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. We have less than a minute to go. He gets it up, and it's good. Weber has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. They'll make the sack. Spikes the ball. From their own 18-yard line, it's third down. And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. It's the ball-hawking freshman, brought down right around the 24-yard line. Whitaker is going to be the first guy to say that this game was his fault. He's just got to get back at practice this week and hope for better things next week.
Yeah, he put so much pressure on himself. And after this kind of performance, you know he's going to be the first guy back in the meeting room, first guy back in the weight room and out on the practice field to try to put this loss behind him and try to get better.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.